In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Amen.
My dear friends, we have gathered here today once again to prepare ourselves for the birthday of our Heavenly Mother. And today, while we prepare ourselves, we reflect on her calling as being the Mother of Hope. So my dear friends, with these thoughts in mind, let us for a short while call to mind our sins and feeling, and let us ask Lord pardon. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts, in my words, in what I have done, what I have failed to do. To my most grievous faults. Therefore I ask the Immaculate Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sin, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. O God, Father of mercies, whose only begotten Son, as he hung upon the cross, chose the Blessed Virgin Mary, his mother, to be our mother also, grant, we pray, that with her loving help, your church may be more fruitful day by day, and exalting in the holiness of her children, may draw to her embrace all the families of the peoples, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns in the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the first letter of Saint Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers, when I came to you, it was not with any show of oratory or philosophy, but simply to tell you what God has guaranteed. During my stay with you, the only knowledge I claimed to have was about Jesus, and only about him as a crucified Christ. Far from relying on any power of my own will, I came among you in great fear and trembling. And in my speeches and the sermons that I gave, there was none of the arguments that belonged to philosophy, only a demonstration of the power of the Spirit. And I did this so that your faith should not depend on human philosophy, but on the power of God. The word of the Lord. Responsorial Psalm, your response is, Lord, I love your commands. Response, Lord, I love your commands. Lord, how I love your law. It is ever in my mind. Your command makes me wiser than my foes, for it is mine forever. Response, Lord, I love your command. I have more insight than all who teach me, for I ponder your will. I have more understanding than the old, for I keep your precepts. Response, Lord, I love your command. I turn my feet from evil paths to obey your word. I have not turned away from your decrees. You yourself have taught me. Response. Please stand for the gospel acclamation. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me. He sent me to bring good news to the poor.
With you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Glory be to you, Lord. Jesus came to Nazareth, where he had been brought up, and went into the synagogue on the Sabbath day as he usually did. He stood up to read, and they handed him the scroll of the prophet Isaiah. Unrolling the scroll, he found the place where it is written, "The Spirit of the Lord has been given to me, for he has anointed me. He has sent me to bring the good news to the poor, to proclaim liberty to captives, and to the blind new sight, to set the downtrodden free, to proclaim the Lord's year of compassion." And he won the approval of all, and they were astonished by the gracious words that came from his lips. They said, "This is Joseph's son, surely." But he replied, "No doubt you will quote me the saying, 'Physician, heal yourself,' and tell me, 'We have heard all that happened in Capernaum. Do the same here in your own countryside.'" And he went on, "I tell you solemnly, no prophet is ever accepted in his own country. There were many widows in Israel, I can assure you, in Elijah's day, when heaven remained shut for 3 years and 6 months, and a great famine raged throughout the land, but Elijah was not sent to any of these. He was sent to a widow at Zarephath, a Sidonian town. And in the prophet Elisha's time, there were many lepers in Israel, but none of these was cured except the Syrian Naaman." When they heard this, everyone in the synagogue was enraged. They sprang to their feet and hustled him out of the town. And they took him up to the brow of the hill their town was built on, intending to throw him down the cliff. But he slipped through the crowd and walked away. The Gospel of the Lord.
Today, when we gather here to prepare ourselves for the birthday of our Heavenly Mother, We are called upon to reflect on her calling as Mother of Hope. My dear friends, how many of y'all feel that she is a hope, that she is our hope? How many of y'all really go to her in times of need? How many of us really use her when we are down? How many of us go turn to her when we feel dejected? I don't know about many of y'all, but I find consolation in her. Just like my earthly mother, when I was down, when I was out, when I felt depressed, I knew one person to talk to, and that was my mother. And the same thing I do ever since God took her away and replaced her with his mother. My dear friends, if you go to the Gospels, this week when Father Amir sent me the schedule and told me my theme, from that time I was trying to figure out what to say, what reading to take. And during this weekend, because it was of the rain, everything was closed, so I had a chance to really sit down and reflect. And the first thing that came to me was a wedding feast at Cana. In a hopeless situation, in a situation where the couple and the family had lost all hope and were sure that in front of their guests they would be disgraced because of the shortage of wine. In such a situation, Our Lady was there. Many people, I said to myself, what an inquisitive person she was. If I was at that wedding, I would have been sitting there. If wine didn't come, I would have said, hey, what useless people, no wine. But she went into the catering area and discovered there was a shortage of wine. And what she says? She tells her son, they have no wine. And he says, my hour's not come. But still, she says, tells the servants, do what he tells you to. My dear friends, at the cross, where it was one of the hopeless situations anyone can face, a situation where anyone can feel dejected at time of death, and here she was there, accepting a responsibility of being the mother of us all. That is why she becomes the mother of hope. While studying the theology of hope in a seminary, we were told that you can live without air for so many minutes, you can live without food for so many hours, so many days, without water for so long. But without hope, not even a second. So all of us who are here today are all alive in a hopeless situation. In a hopeless situation, we are alive. Why? Because we have hope. Just yesterday at lunch in the parish house, we were discussing about the situation in the country. And it came up that somebody said, the situation in Pakistan is a hopeless situation. It was mentioned somewhere in some article in the papers or somewhere. And my response would have been to that, then according to what we learned in the seminary, we should have all been dead. But because we are people of hope, we are alive today. And my dear friends, it's not that because I am a child of hope, my mother is a mother of hope, that I keep that hope to myself. But I'm called to spread that hope to one another. Give that consolation to one another. Give that hope to one another. If she is my mother, she calls me to go out to spread that hope in this world. If she is your mother, she expects you to do the same. मेरे अजीजों, आज जब हम अपनी तैयारी के अमल में अपनी आसमानी माँ की यौम वलादत की तैयारी में हम आज उम्मीद पर गौर करते हैं, खास तौर पर हमारी माँ मरियम जो है उम्मीद की माँ। और आज जब मैं इस बात पर गौर कर रहा था तो फौरन मेरे सामने जो है काने गलील का वाकया, जब शादी के मौके पर मैं गट गई और उस वक्त मां मरियम की कोई जिम्मेदारी नहीं थी कि जाकर चेक करने, वो केटरर नहीं थी, वो उसकी जिम्मेदारी ये नहीं दिया गया कि आप केटरिंग बिजनेस शुरू कर ले। लेकिन क्योंकि वो अपने आप को उम्मीदों की मां समझते हैं, इसलिए वो खुद जाकर मालूम किया कि मैं गट गई और अपनी अपने बेटे से कहा मैं खत्म हो गया। और यीशु ने क्या कहा, ए औरत मेरा वक्त नहीं पहुंचा। और उसने जाकर उनसे कहा जो ये कहता है वो ही करो। एक ना उम्मीद की हालत में हमारी आसमानी मां उम्मीद दिलाता है, एक ऐसी हालत में जहां खानदान और जोड़े की बेइज्जती हो सकता था, उसने उनको उम्मीद दिलाकर कहा कि जो ये कहता है वो ही करो। मेरे अजीजों, जब खुदावन्द यीशु मसीह सलीब पर मर रहे थे, उस नाउमीदी हालत में मां मरियम ने एक बहुत बड़ी जिम्मेदारी उठाई कि वो हम सब की मां बनने के लिए बुलाई गई। और एक ना उम्मीद की हालत में उसने दुनिया को उम्मीद दिलाया कि मैं आपकी मां हूं। मेरे अजीजों, आज जब हम अपने आप को तैयार करें अपनी आसमानी मां की यौम विलादत के लिए, आज हम अपने आप से पूछते हैं, अगर मैं कहता हूं कि ये मेरी मां है तो जो ये कहती है वो मुझे करना है कि जाकर इस दुनिया में, इस इस्लामी रियासत में उम्मीद का पैगाम दे। उम्मीद एक ना उम्मीद की हालत में इस मुल्क में जहां एक नाउमीद की हालत है, वहां उम्मीद लाए लोगों को। और नया, ये ना सिर्फ मेरी जिम्मेदारी बल्कि आप सब की जिम्मेदारी है जो इस मां की पुजारियां हैं, जो इस मां को अपनी मां मानते हैं, जो अपने आप को इस मां की फर्जंद कहलाती है। ये आपकी जिम्मेदारी है कि आप जाकर इस नाउमीद की हालत में इस मुल्क को, इस इस्लामी रियासत में उम्मीद का पैगाम दें। आई मेरी जीजो, आज सोचें, आज गौर करें। बहुत आसान है कहने के लिए कि मैं मां मरियम की का बेटा हूं, लेकिन इस फ़राइज निभाना बहुत मुश्किल है, लेकिन नामुमकिन नहीं। हम सब जो इस मां की औलाद है, इस मां के फर्जंद है, आई आज हम फैसला करें कि हम इस नाउमीद हालत में हम उम्मीद का पैगाम दें। आई चलम एक खामोशी में इन बातों पर गौर करें और इसके बाद खुदा की जरूरत मुनाजात पेश करें। आमीन। Page 487. Let us give thanks to Christ our Lord, who loves and cherishes His church.
Be near us, Lord, this evening. Response:
Be near us, Lord, this evening.
Lord Jesus, grant that all men may be saved and come to the knowledge of the truth. Response:
Be near us, Lord, this evening.
Protect Pope Francis and Benny, our Bishop. Help them, Lord, in your strength and mercy. Response:
Be near us, Lord, this evening.
Support those who meet with difficulty and disappointment. Renew their confidence and sense of purpose. Response:
Be near us, Lord, this evening.
Christ, our loving Lord, in your kindness be with the sick and poor, the weak and the dying. Bring them your comfort. Response:
Be near us, Lord, this evening.
We commend to you all those who in their lifetime shared in the sacred ministry. Let them praise you forever in heaven. Response:
Be near us, Lord, this evening. Aaj hum khaas tor par dua karein मां मरियम के फर्जंद के लिए कि खुदावन हमें तौफीक दे ताकि हम अपनी आसमानी मां की तरह हम भी इस दुनिया में उम्मीद का पैगाम दिलाएं। अजीज उस मकसद के लिए दुआ करें।
ऐ खुदा, हमारी दुआ सुन।
आज हम खास तौर पर दुआ करें उन लोगों के लिए जिन्होंने किसी खास इरादे, किसी खास मकसद से ये अपने आप को तैयार कर रहे हैं आने वाली ईद के लिए, कि खुदावन उनकी मकसद को पूरा करें, उनकी उम्मीदों को बरकत दे ताकि वो जो कुछ वो मांगे खुदा उनको देगा। अजीज उस मकसद के लिए दुआ करें।
ऐ खुदा, हमारी दुआ सुन।
Grant us, Lord, we pray, the joy of continued health of mind and body, and through the intercession of the Blessed Virgin Mary, free us of this present sadness, fill us with eternal joy, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
ready your prayers and last sacrifice be acceptable to God, your mighty Father. Amen. Receive our offerings, O Lord, and transform them into the mystery of salvation, so that by its power we may be set aflame with the charity of the Virgin Mary, Mother of the Church, and with her may be united more closely to the works of redemption, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to Lord our God. It is truly right and just, a duty and our salvation, all of them remain to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. Receiving your word in her immaculate heart, she was found worthy of to conceive him in her virgin's womb and give birth to the Creator. She nurtured the beginning of the Church. Standing beside the cross, she received the testament of divine love and took to herself the sons and daughters, those who won by the death of Christ and are born to heavenly life. As the apostles awaited the Spirit you had promised, she joined her supplication to the prayers of the disciples and so became the pattern of the Church at prayer. Raised to the glory of heaven, she accompanied your pilgrim Church with her mother's love and watches in kindness over the Church's homeward steps until the Lord's days shall come in glorious splendor. And so with the angels and saints we praise you, as without end we acclaim.
Holy.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, Father of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them, let you fall, so they become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he betrayed willingly this passion, he took bread, giving thanks, broke it, gave the disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave the disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread, therefore we celebrate the memorial of your death and resurrection. We offer you, Lord, a bread of life and chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we began to wonder the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your Church is spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Penny, our Bishop, and all the clergy.
Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed Apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, and with him, and in him, God Almighty Father, in you, the Holy Spirit, All glory and honor is yours forever and ever. आइए हम उस दृष्टि से दुआ करें जो हमारे खुदा ने हमें सिखाया है। ऐ हमारे बाप, तू जो आसमान पर है, तेरा नाम पाक माना जाए, तेरी बादशाही आए, तेरी मर्जी ऐसी हो। एक दम से मिन्नत करते हैं सब बदियों से बचा आदमी सलामती बरकत की शफ़ी तौफीक से मुबारक पूरी होने और मसीहा ने का इंतजार करते हुए हर वक्त गुनाहों से आजाद और मुसीबत से महफूज रहे। ऐ खुदा यीशु मसीह, तूने अपने रसूलों से कहा कि मैं तुम्हारे पास सलाम भी छोड़े जाता हूँ, मैं अपनी सलाम देता हूँ, हमारे गुनाहों पर नेक ऋषि की मान पर नजर कर और सुबह सलाम था बख्श, तेरी मर्जी के मुताबिक है। सलामती हर वक्त आपके साथ हो। आई भी तुझे सलामती चाहिए। एक खुदा की बर्री खुदा मसीह खुदा का बरा जो हमारी खातिर से अगर फिदिया बना, मुबारक हम सब जो बरी की सियाफत के लिए बुलाए गए। Let us pray. Having received the pledge of redemption and of life, we humbly pray, O Lord, that with the Blessed Virgin's motherly help, your Church may teach all nations by proclaiming the Gospel, and through the grace of the outpouring of the Spirit, fill the whole earth through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And
may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit descend upon you and reign with you forever. Our Mass is ended. Go and announce the Gospel of the Lord.
Amen.